back, my YouTube family. How y'all doing, man? Hope everybody's having a good afternoon. Hasn't been such a bad afternoon for me so far. But it's time I smoke one. So as I said in my previous video, I was going to share it with you all. So what we getting ready to do today, we're about to do a review on the brand new 2020 version of the Bowtie Cigar. See what we got inside of the pouch. So, what we're gonna smoke today is the all new Bowtie White Label Couture. As I said in my previous video, this particular cigar is done by a buddy of mine, a longtime friend of mine here in St. Louis, who is a blender of his own cigars, Billy Bowtie, Mr. Bowtie himself, BowtieCigar.com. The name of the cigars are Bowtie Cigars. And the saying is, what color is your bowtie? So these bowties have come in all different types of colors and sizes, and this is what we offer 2020. This is going to be a 6x54 pyramid, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, 6x54 pyramid. Good looking stick, man. Everything Billy does is going to be artistic, man. We got a lot of band on that cigar, but like we always say, we're not going to smoke the band. All right? So, if you guys didn't see my previous video, as opposed to this particular cigar being the newest version of a Bowtie cigar, the 2020 version, what we had in the previous is the Bowtie copper label. Also, we've had the Bowtie platinum label. As you can see, man, the box is, man, very artistic, man. You know, this is what we call branding. This is what my man Bowtie does. In addition to those, we had the Bowtie 314, which is a cigar that he blended to pay homage to his folk here in St. Louis and in the Metro East. I mean, it takes a lot, man. I've smoked a lot of cigars, man, and I don't see guys spend money on the advertisement that this man has and the work that he's put into it. And today, we are smoking the Bowtie White Label Couture. So, cowboy ain't gonna mess around, man. We're gonna get into this thing, man, and see what's up with it. This thing is dressed in a that's an Ecuadorian Habano wrapper. We've got a Nicaraguan binder, and we've got Dominican Olor fillers. This is a Dominican cigar out of Dominican Republic, Santiago, Dominican Republic, if I'm not mistaken, which is the factory that my man Billy has been dealing with for quite some time. This is not one of these cigars that someone sent over a batch of cigars and said, smoke this one and smoke this one and smoke this one and tell us which one you think you like, and then we'll ship you some. No, my man has been to the DR. This is no bullshit. This took time to do. He's been to the DR. He's been to the factories. He's walked the fields. He's made love to the tobacco. So this is all hand selected by him. You know, that's what makes this journey of his so special. So we're going to see what's up with this cigar. This will be my first time smoking it, and I'm going to share it with y'all. On the smell, got some sweet tobacco. Even got a little hint of like almost some peppermint. A little barnyard and hay there. Sweet tea and coffee on the foot. Yeah, I'm definitely getting, for whatever reason, a little peppermint smell there on the wrapper. But not bad. So, cowboy gonna do a straight cut on this thing, man. And we gonna cut him up, light him up, and smoke him up, and tell y'all what I think, in my honest opinion, about my man's cigar. Got a medium draw to it, just a tad bit snug. Got some sweet tea, a little hint of peppermint there on the cold draw for me. Same thing on the smear. Tad bit of creaminess there. So we ain't gonna mess around, man. Let's get him lit up. And let's see what's up with the 2020 Bowtie White Label Couture. I hope everybody's having a good day, man. Hope everybody's gonna having a good weekend so far. So far for me, so good. We're gonna make the best of it. We're gonna get this smoke in and we're gonna relax and we're gonna make it do what it do. So, on the initial light up, on the retro hill, got just a tad bit of, I'm going to call it a white pepper retro. I'm feeling a little mintiness on my lips, but in a good way. Got a nice coffee note there. Some earthiness. It's got about a medium foot smoke to it, I'm gonna say. I didn't give it a perfect light. Let's get that lit up over there. There we go. Got a nice little mintiness there, man. A little flavor mint there on the retro and on the taste as well. Some coffee, a little bit of maybe chocolate cocoa going. A very nice earthiness. So, here we are on the Bowtie White Label Couture. Cowboy's gonna get through this first third, man. I'm gonna come back and let y'all know where we at on this thing. But the draw is nice. It felt a little bit tight, a little bit restricted at first, but I don't think I'm gonna have any problems with the draw. It's opened up pretty good there. So we'll be back with the first third and let you know where we at with this. Bowtie. All right, YouTube. I am back. Well, first of all, YouTube, let me show you guys the shirt. It's my Cowboy's shirt. That's my take on it. So, if you all are interested in any of the merchandise, I will put a link at the bottom. The link will also be in the description of the video. So we are back with the 6x54 Pyramid Couture White Label by Bowtie Cigars. As you can see, I got a very nice ash going there. Not the perfect burn so far, but the burn is not bad. We're gonna hope that it's gonna straighten itself out. We'll see. I am gonna have to pull that band off, that first band here real soon. Nicely dressed cigar, man. You know, just like a cigar that I smoked not long ago, which was that CAO, the 2020 CAO Vision. The cigar is dressed for the occasion, tuxedo style. That's the way we roll around here. So shout out to Billy Bowtie. Mr. Bowtie himself, for that vision. But on the first third on this cigar, the cigar has a decent draw to it. Medium draw, not having any problems. Decent foot smoke. About a medium, I'm going to say about medium on the foot smoke. Nice cool smoking cigar. On that first third, I picked up some coffee. Some cocoa, got a little bit of nutmeg spice going on there, like a bacon spice. And that retro is still like a very nice mild white pepper with like a mint. I don't know if it's a spearmint, some type of flavor mint. I got a mintiness going on there. And maybe even a tad bit of citrus, a little bit of citrus, I think maybe. Being a Dominican stick, it's got a nice little dry earthiness to it. The woody note that I'm getting, it's almost like a boxwood note. If you got boxwood trees, if you've ever cut your boxwood trees, it's kind of got that type of a note. Not so much of a cedar or oak, but maybe a boxwood for me. It's got a, like I say, a decent ash, decent burn. And I'm gonna say right now that the cigar is smoking medium in strength, medium in body, and medium in flavors. So that's where we are right now. And what I decided to pair with this, since I was on it, it's my man Billy Bowtie, black-owned company. Shouldn't make any difference about the cigar, whether it's black-owned or not. But we have to say that, man. I am so proud of this gentleman, man. So what I decided to pair with it, I pulled out a bourbon that I got my hands on a while back. Couldn't find this bourbon in St. Louis anywhere. So thanks to my man Ryan Real. Shout out to Ryan Real, Ryan Real TV. You guys ain't checking out Ryan Real, you better go do so. I'm sure you are, because you probably found me through him. But Ryan picked this up for me, man, and he sent it to me because I couldn't find it. Bro Brothers Bourbon. It's a black-owned bourbon distillery. The first black-owned bourbon distillery in Kentucky. And they're located in Louisville, Kentucky, I believe. So, black-owned cigar, black-owned bourbon. Why not? Got a really nice smell on the bourbon. I can tell it's a young bourbon. You can look at the color. It's got a nice, light, tea-like color to it. Got some nice fruity notes there. A little bit of vanilla. But just smelling, I can tell that it's a young whiskey. Let's taste it and see what we got. Salute. Okay. And I think this bourbon is 41% alcohol by volume. So 82 proof. It's about right. Not bad. Young, but not bad. But you know, bourbon distillery. Young, just now starting out. 5-10 years from now, that bourbon is gonna have a whole nother flavor to it. But right now, so far, so good. I'm enjoying it. So, Cowboy gonna smoke this thing down, man, to the second half, man. And I'll get back and let y'all know where we are with the Couture White Label by Bowtie. Y'all relax. Salute. All right, YouTube family. Cowboy's back with the second portion of the Bowtie Couture White Label by Mr. Bowtie himself. My partner, my friend, my brother. To me, definitely smoking like a Dominican stick. There are several Dominican sticks that I enjoy. Then there are some that are just okay for me. But this cigar here is smoking pretty good so far. The burn has been wavy up and down on me, but it tended to straighten itself out both times. The cigar held a pretty doggone good ash. A little bit over an inch, I would say. The burn straightened itself back out. No relights, no touch-ups to this point. It's just continuing to correct itself. Decent looking ash. I failed to mention the construction of the cigar. It was a rustic looking cigar. Medium brown tint to it. Visible seams on it, as you can see. Some parts of the seam Looks like it may want to peel away, but it hasn't done that as of yet. Just a rustic looking stick, man. But a good looking stick. Good smoking cigar so far. From the initial light up, the draw has opened up on the cigar quite a bit. So I'm not having any issues with the draw. Still got that dry earth going on. Tends to want to dry the mouth out just a little bit, but not in a bad way. It's got a semi-sweet tobacco core to it. Still got that nice mild pepper, minty retro to it for me, like a citrus mint. Very nice retro in my opinion. Got a cocoa note to it. Still got that bacon spice. Maybe I'm gonna call it a nutmeg. Picked up a nice sweet tea note on it. Like a minty sweet tea. Almost like a, I don't know why. It's been a while since I could pick up mint on a cigar, but I'm tasting like a mint julep, like the drink, you know, or even got some chocolate there. Brown sugar, chocolate, maybe like a chocolate mint, maybe the chocolate mint candy. Best as I can describe it, but so far so good. The earthiness is definitely there. We're going to continue to smoke this thing down to the last third. Cowboy will come back and let y'all know how this thing scores. In my opinion. Y'all relax. I'll be back. Well, 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 family. I'm back. I am back with the Bow Tie White Label Couture by Bow Tie Cigars. The 6x54 pyramid, not a bad stick at all. I think I failed to mention, this cigar goes for about $10 a stick. On the site, you can buy them a 5-pack for $50. In my opinion, definitely one and a half in the box, man. I'm glad I got a few more. As you can see, that burn once again is getting just a little bit wonky, but every time it does that, it comes back to straighten itself out. Ash is just trying to get just a little bit flaky there on the last third. Have not had to relight it, have not had to touch it up. But like I say, smoking like a Dominican stick in my opinion. The rustic firm look to the cigar, the wrapper did hold true, although it's got some visible seams there. I was afraid that it might try to peel away on me, but it did not. On that last third, picked up some more mineral earth, which I come to expect that Dominican twang, as we call it, when you've got a Dominican cigar with that Dominican Allure filler in it. Got that nice dry earthiness still to it. The retro hell here on the last third began to pick up a little bit on the white pepper. Less of the mint. Mintiness on the retro, but I can still tell it's there. I still get the minty feel in the mouth, definitely on the lips from the wrapper. I don't know what that is, but it's not bad. On that last third, I even picked up some nuttiness. I'm not sure exactly what nut that is. The cocoa is a cocoa powder for me, and believe it or not, a tad bit of leather jumped up out the coconut grove on me on that cigar, man. On that last third. Y'all know I like that leather. The bacon spice is there. That sweet tea, mint julep type note. Chocolate mint, you know. The flavor profile has been doing this on me, but it's been nice. I have enjoyed the cigar. Billy Kane, good job, bro. We've been waiting on this 2020 edition, man. Like I say, I'm glad I got more of them to smoke. So, family, I'm sorry if there seems to be a delay in the video, but I had a phone call I had to take. So, we nubbing this bad boy out today. Y'all see I got my nubber there. All right, so, on the final on the bow tie, Couture White Label. As Cowboy scores this cigar tonight, on my scale of 1 to 10, I gave the construction a 9, I gave the burn a 9, I gave the flavors an 8, the body a 7, and for complexion and transition, I gave it a 7. Tally that all up, that gives the Bowtie White Label Couture an overall score of a solid 8 for tonight. Definitely an above average cigar. Definitely one to have. So, good job. Been a while since I nubbed one out, but I really, really am enjoying the cigar. So, this is Cowboy. What color is your bow tie? That's my take on it. Peace.